yeah. I hope you're having a great day. It's another cold day. A little snow coming down outside. Part of winter. Surrounded by puppies today. That makes my world fun. Mitochondria are an important part of the cells in our body. They provide energy to the cells so we can function normally. If our mitochondria are not functioning as they should, our immune system and cellular signaling become stressed. Healthy mitochondria can help to prevent people from developing chronic health conditions. Mitochondria DNA, or mtDNA, mutations were discovered in 1988, so this is basically a new field. First, early researchers took our inability to exercise to heart, and they went to work. I'm going to share several research articles on muscle fatigue and the potential cause of it. So don't let anyone tell you that you just need to exercise and you'll be fine. Because we have exercise intolerance. But that doesn't mean we shouldn't try to be active to the best of our ability. It just means that we're going to struggle. We'll need breaks. And most definitely, we won't be able to do the same repetitions of things that we once did as we live with fibromyalgia. Second, today I want to bring us up to speed as to where research is today on exercise intolerance and muscle fatigue and fibromyalgia, and how it might be due to our mitochondria. So here we go. It's wild to think that our mitochondria have their own set of DNA called mtDNA, but that's the case. They are inherited, and only recently has it been discovered that we can inherit from our fathers, albeit rare. In the past, it was mostly thought to be inherited from our mothers. There are also more than 250 pathogenic mtDNA mutations identified. What is interesting about mtDNA is that they are different from our nuclear DNA, but nuclear DNA can code to mtDNA. The main purpose of mitochondria is to support aerobic respiration and the bulk of our cellular ATP, or adenosine triphosphate. The human central and peripheral nervous system relies on ATP signaling. Mitochondria produce 90% of the energy our body needs to function, and ATP plays a large part in that. Basically, fibromyalgia affects the whole system, almost every part, and each one is affected by mitochondria. Just take a look at our symptoms. Pain all over, stiff muscles, activity level down by 50% from what we were prior to our illness, brain fog, forgetfulness, cold hands. Just imagine, every cell in our body must make its own energy. And if a cell isn't capable of making energy, then it's dysfunctional. Fibromyalgia is a complex disease. So we might see a rheumatologist for the pain and fatigue, a gastroenterologist for our IBS, a neurologist for neuropathy, a cardiologist for vasovagal syncope, and the list goes on. A muscle is designed to make energy, and when the cells in the muscle and body aren't functioning properly, we get pain and other symptoms. Mitochondria function is central to health. We need to make sure we have good gut function too. I did a video on leaky gut here. Feeding your cells with healthy eating is truly essential. So let's go back in time a little. In 2002, researchers stated in an article that muscle function in fibromyalgia patients is globally impaired. In 2003, researchers stated their results may suggest that impaired muscle metabolism and/or microcirculatory disorder contribute to impaired muscular performance in fibromyalgia after performing only half the amount of work that healthy controls were able to perform. In 2004, magnetic resonance was used to investigate the metabolic and functional status of muscles of fibromyalgia patients. Researchers determined objective evidence of metabolic abnormalities in the quadricep muscles consistent with weakness and fatigue. So in 2005, researchers conducted a study to determine if microcirculation is indeed an issue in fibro. They found fibro patients had fewer capillaries in the nail fold and significantly more capillary dilations and irregular formations than healthy controls, as well as less peripheral blood flow than healthy controls. And it appears that these irregularities were no different from systemic scleroderma and autoimmune disease. In 2013, researchers concluded that there's a greater impairment in muscle contractility associated with exertion and exercise capacity in fibromyalgia. In 2021, researchers investigated brain functions and creatine metabolites in patients with fibro. They found abnormalities in creatine energy metabolism and deficient energy levels, which might be related to the brain pathology in fibromyalgia. And they also correlated that to high pain, stress, and PTSD. In a study completed in November of 2022 and released just this year, January of 2023, researchers investigated mitochondrial dysfunction in fibromyalgia by looking at the consumption of muscle oxygen during exercise. Healthy control values were significantly altered by the fatigue protocol, which is what normally happens in healthy people. This means that in healthy controls, the consumption of muscle oxygen that's needed to work their muscles decreased in muscle oxygen saturation and then increased in deoxygenated hemoglobin so they could utilize oxygen for energy consumption. That's interesting. In fibromyalgia patients, there weren't any significant alterations in their values. Instead, their numbers remained stable during the entire duration of the fatigue protocol, which would explain the lack of ability to recover quickly or endure a physical demand. The muscles weren't consuming oxygen in the same way as healthy participants. They recommended future studies explore the impact of pharmacological and non-pharmacological therapies on the consumption of muscle oxygen in people with fibro and with menopausal women. In 2012, a study of 14 postmenopausal women with fibromyalgia and 23 healthy control postmenopausal subjects, the exercise protocol was performed. They did knee extensions and used cuff occlusion to measure forearm arterial blood flow. They found an alteration of muscle oxygen utilization in the fibro population immediately after the fatiguing exercise with longer oxygenation recovery time. These findings could reflect altered mitochondrial function. Quote, mitochondrial dysfunction could also cause abnormal synthesis of adenosine triphosphate, ATP, resulting in insufficient energy supply and muscle fatigue, unquote. In 2020, researchers stated their results suggest that fibro has mitochondrial dysfunction, but it's unclear if inactivity, obesity, aging, and pain are a cause of, the result of, or coincidental to the mitochondrial dysfunction. So researchers aren't really sure of why mitochondrial dysfunction exists in fibromyalgia. Symptoms of mitochondrial diseases depend on the cell of the body that's affected. Symptoms can be mild or severe and involve one or more organs and occur at any age. So, we have muscle pain and gastro issues. Some have acid reflux or diabetes. Some have migraines and thyroid problems. But I don't think there's a real consensus on fibromyalgia and mitochondrial dysfunction yet, but it will be interesting to hear more about this topic. So they can't check our ATP levels in our blood, but doctors use other measures to determine our health. Adenosine is used to check for syncope issues, sometimes during a tilt table test or some other measure. But doctors might also choose to use tests like an MRI, ERG, EKG, audiogram, blood tests for thyroid dysfunction, blood tests for genetic DNA testing, a review of a patient's history, a complete physical exam, a neurological exam, a metabolic exam that includes blood and urine tests, and if needed, a cerebral spinal fluid test. Treatments include vitamins, exercise, and strength training like swimming, conserving our energy, and other treatments as necessary. But you do want to avoid the following because they could make our medical condition worse, like exposure to heat or cold, starving our body, you need to eat healthy, a lack of sleep. Having good sleep patterns is important, avoiding stressful situations, and avoid use of alcohol, cigarettes, and MSG, or monosodium glutamate, that flavor enhancer commonly used in processed foods. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Is there something else that you would like me to cover in regards to mitochondria? Or is there something else you'd like me to cover? Put it in the comment section. Or feel free. I send you gentle hugs and support. Love you. Is to support aerobic respiration. In 2004, mtDNA postmenopausal mitochondrial